Hola amigos, hola amigas, welcome, bienvenido, Christ be salam, welcome to the channel, y'all. Here I have a Hoover-matic twin tub. I think this one is from the 70s. Let's take a look at the back of it. The cord is hidden away in there. Press to restart heater. Now, this has been resprayed. I'm not very fond of the color, to be honest. And the top is all kind of chipped and everything. So what I'm gonna do to the top is I'm going to strip the paint off it, bring it back to its original color. I might have to respray it, but that is ugly. The twin tub itself is in really good condition. Actually, it's in excellent condition. So here we have the hose. There we have the twin tub itself. That was the spoon I was using. Last time you might have seen some shorts on this. But everything works on it fine. There's the spinner, there. So everything works on it fine. There's the pulsator. Apart from it has a little leak. So what I need to do is get this up on its side and I'll show you the leak. Okay, so I've actually turned this upside down. And this main pipe here from the pump has a leak. That's where it's leaking from. And the pipe goes all the way down into there. So the part of the pipe that is leaking is this part here. So what I'm going to be doing is reinforcing that pipe. There's a split on it. I've let it dry since I've used it so I could fix it. And I got two products. I got this quick leak putty, repair putty, which is gonna repair this end. And then I've got some of this sealing tape. So it's a kind of self-sealing tape that you wrap around it that I'm gonna use to reinforce the pipe up as much as I can. Just to give it some extra strength. So I'm going to crack on with that. Okay, so I have to wait 1 hour for that to cure, and then I can use the tape. Okay, so that is now hardened and it is rock hard. Now I'm going to use this tape to wrap around it and up to the pipe as far as I can reach. So let's get that done. Okay, now that that's done, turn it upside down, let's get some water in it, and let's give it a go. Okay. There's nothing on the floor yet. I'll leave it on heat. There's no heating. So I'll come back to you once it's reached temperature. Okay, so it's 16 degrees. Okay, it's nice and steamy, and we are just a few degrees off. I've got two limescale tablets I'm going to pop in. I've got some scent beads I'm going to pop in. And I got some Daz whites and colours to pop in. First time really using this, so it's a motor, turn it on. Let's get all that mixed up. It smells nice. Okay, let's start adding stuff. Refilled tongs with a glitter on them. So there's no leaking so far. There will be now because it's a splasher later. That's why you have this lid to put on. But because I'm making a video, I'm going to have to leave it off. Okay, so set the timer. I wish it had a reverse function on it. Okay, that is done its first spin. The suds are back in. Now I need to do the rinsing. Meanwhile, I can put the washing back. More washing in. Thank you. some fabric softener. Right, I fixed it. The spinner pulley, I put a new belt on it, a brand new belt, on the pump. And the spinner pulley, the belt was loose, so I had to loosen off one of the pulleys, move it along, tighten it up to tighten up the pulley. And I think it's working now, so we shall try again.
there we go, straight away. I've got a bit more water back into this. Spin this when the heat is on. Thank you. softener. Final spin. Brake on. I'm going to put the heater on. It's 40, but I want to get it up to 50, so I'm going to turn the heater on. Okay guys, so we're back up at 50 degrees. I'm going to put in some more detergent. That's what you did back then. Now I'm going to feed some t-shirts in. And these are going to knot up lovely. Knotted ball of t-shirts. That'll be enough. Turn that on to full.
Lower you back down so you can see.
Hoover tangulator. Just gonna leave that there a second. Thank you.
floor is soaked. The floor is soaked. And the twins are... because obviously I'm doing it with a lid on, because otherwise I wasn't going to film an edge. Okay, that's our two turns in the twin tub. Let's try and unknot everything.
This is identical to the machine that my Auntie Glenys used to have. I remember sitting there watching her do her washing when I was a kid. I was 6. Okay, that's a lot. Thank you. done. I'm gonna give this one more turn. Thank you.
not going to be doing any more laundry, so I'm not interested in the water going back in, so we can go out. Put the lid on, lift it up to drain from there, turn it on. Once it goes past the pulsator, I'll take it off.
And there we go. All clean. All washed. Apart from the initial hiccup. It's because quite a big space in here. It's quite a nice size. This kind of feels like basically what you can fit in there is a load for that. So you can go in, out, in, out, in, out, which is really good. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed. Bit of a hiccup, but that's the first time ever using one of these Hoover-matic. And now I got that belt issue fixed. There's still a slight leak issue from the back that I saw, so I'm gonna have to wait until this dries tomorrow and then tip it over again and have a look. But there we go. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye y'all.